This ain't the intro, this the entree. It's Vach Lombardi. We're taking a look at Xavier McKinney, safety from Alabama today. He's the other safety at the top of your boards. The other is Grant Delpit. You can go watch that video. But Grant is more of a free safety, one high, three high, you know, rangy type of cat or whatever. He's going to play mostly in the defensive backfield. That's different. Xavier McKinney is a strong safety. He's going to be in the box. He's going to be chasing tight ends around. Depending on the size and skill matchup, he can probably do some things versus slot receivers. We'll take a look at that. But I think where he really puts the nipple on the titty is being an angry, aggressive, run-stopping, tackly guy, right? Take a look at this. That's where he makes his money at. If you think about a phrase that I coined last year as a missile guy, right? We're talking about big missile and little missile from last year, Abrams and Savage. I think Xavier McKinney is the same kind of guy. You know, just one of those guys that'll risk CTE for the tackle. You know, one of those dudes, one of those wood layers, one of those tone setters. You know, he makes a big hit and it rallies the whole defense or whatever. I think Xavier McKinney is absolutely one of those guys, man. He has his big hits because of his pursuit. His closing burst is so insane, right? Now, let's just be aware that sometimes that pursuit and closing burst will get him in trouble. I would like for you all to stick and watch the rest of the video and we'll see what I mean by that, right? But in terms of Lane Wood, and first of all, he's an eye reader, which is always good. He's playing from deep here. And, you know, like I said, Alabama sometimes play him as the deep safety. I don't think he's going to make a full-time career, you know, playing deep. He could probably do, like, some cover two things where he's responsible for, like, half the field or whatever. You know, as long as he can read the quarterback, he's good. But in terms of range, I don't think we'll ever see Xavier McKinney go from like the right hash mark to the left numbers making a play on the football. Like he'll be a couple steps behind on that. So we're not talking about that. But if he's playing deep and he's reading the eyes of the quarterback and he has to diagnose things in front of him and have a closing burst to make a play on it, let's take a look at his closing burst. Absolutely, to where he could just close in and make a play on a pass or whatever. I think he could do things like that. He's gonna be solid versus the tight end. I mean, you see that Thaddeus Moss, when he did make plays in the Alabama game, it wasn't on Xavier McKinney in terms of a pure coverage situation or whatever. Xavier McKinney is probably gonna be one of your tight end busters. Now let's talk about tight end busters for a minute. Let's talk about the next few plays I'm gonna show you for Xavier McKinney and kind of talk about the difference when we talk about coverage. Xavier McKinney traveling with people, no problem, right? In terms of, can he cover Thaddeus Moss right here? Sure, he's covered Thaddeus Moss right there. He's considered covered, right? But there's a portion of the play that comes after that, like the ball in flight mode that Xavier may have a problem with or whatever, right? But in terms of covering folk, take a look at him versus this slot receiver here. Covering folk, boom, 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 cool. Now, this receiver here, he's not like a quick, super twitchy guy. He's not a super nuanced route runner or a route runner or whatever. Say that five times fast. But I think Xavier McKinney can win this mismatch because he's more of a simpler type of receiver to play against. What I mean by that is you wouldn't put Xavier McKinney versus like if Amari Cooper lined up in the slot. Is Xavier McKinney good enough to walk down and cover him? I wouldn't do that. But if a Alshon Jeffrey or something lines up in the slot, you will feel better about Xavier McKinney covering somebody bigger that's not going to blow you away with speed and quickness and route running, right? But that's just the traveling portion of things, right? Let me isolate this so I can show you. Okay, cool. What we've saw is Xavier McKinney versus receivers traveling or covering, right? What actually happens when the ball is in the air? Because that's a whole nother part of coverage that we got to talk about, right? He's not really a natural corner. So you may run into a situation where somebody could, at the top of a stem, they could burst away from him. We've seen that happen. Or you could just see somebody flat out jump over him because he may not have natural cornerback abilities. So certain mismatches will be good for him. certain mismatches will be a little different. If the quarterback is going to see if a receiver is covered and go to another, you know, option or whatever, Xavier McKinney will be good there. But you may run into a quarterback that's willing to shoot that shot and say, okay, Xavier's on my tall guy. Let me play 50-50 ball with my tall guy. And you may run into a situation like this with Xavier McKinney. It's a rare example, but hey, it's an example that I think is valid. But let's just continue to watch some film though. How about this play? I noticed from this Ole Miss from 2018. And, you know, they've done it a lot less, but it is a play that I noticed. So let me just kind of, you know, talk about what I did see here. They got McKinney at the deep safety here. And sometimes you will see the more space he has to diagnose in front of him, the more kind of lost in coverage he looks. That's the DK Metcalf play that he just kind of smoked everybody or whatever. And, you know, you can look at some of his 2019 film and just kind of, you know, if he's in zone coverage, reading things in front of him, will he take the cheese? Will he take the small play and a bigger play goes behind him? You know what I mean? And if you take a look at the corner at the bottom of your screen here, let me move this out the way. If you take a look at the corner at the bottom of your screen, he's playing this technique as if there's probably going to be some help behind him. Possibly. But hey, as you see, Xavier McKinney was not there. Xavier McKinney, he took the cheese. He played down on AJ Brown right here. So it's something interesting to think about. Chat box, if you have a different idea of what you saw there. Like I said, I don't know the defensive call, but this corner did seem to think that he had some type of help here. I think that'll be interesting to kind of diagnose and figure out. But in coverage isn't the only place he can cause turnovers, man. He can also make turnovers just flat out being a missile. Is this a valid offensive formation? I don't know. But yeah, even if he's not catching interceptions on people, he can still make plays hitting, being a missile and causing fumbles, right? As long as he's around the football laying hits on folk, I think I think there's a high probability that he can cause turnovers in that way. So it just depends on how you want your turnovers, you know, if you want, or let's say big plays, let's not say turnovers, right? Because if you're Xavier McKinney, you can get sacks, you can get probably get more forced fumbles, you'll probably tip a lot more passes or whatever. You know, if you're thinking about another safety, they're probably the ones that get you more deep pass deflections and interceptions or whatnot, right? It just depends on what you want for your team. The YouTube Illuminati is taking money away from your favorite content creators, and people often ask the best way to support the channel directly. I tell them that subscribing on my Patreon. Just $1 a month would increase production and the frequency of uploads. Basically, that means more content for you. For less than a bag of almond M&Ms, you can support the channel, call dibs on requests for future videos, and you can have access to Patreon-exclusive material like my throwback film sessions. That's patreon.com/VachLombardi. I appreciate the support. Doski Woski. Salute. So I didn't want to add this to the highlight reel because I feel like this particular set of opinions didn't really express the type of player that Xavier McKinney was, but I think there's a discussion surrounding it. So I decided to add these next handful of plays or whatever. So when we talk about Grant Delpit as a safety or whatever, you'll hear some people say, I don't want Grant Delpit because I don't want a safety that's going to miss tackles. Well, sometimes Xavier McKinney, with his super pursuit, with his aggression, sometimes it's just the angle that he takes or whatever. Xavier McKinney can miss tackles as well. This is McKinney coming from deep right here. He's going to come down against Clyde and he's just kind of going to miss him. You know what I mean? That could be a pursuit thing. I don't know what you want to call it or whatever, but we're not just going to freely absolve Xavier McKinney of tackling responsibility, right? We're going to get Jordan Jefferson in space, which is another example of a guy that I wouldn't want Xavier McKinney in space with, right? A guy that's very sudden, you know what I mean? Boom, things like that. Xavier McKinney can miss a tackle there. We just got to be aware. And all this was from the LSU game. Here's another example of his super burst and pursuit proving to work against him there. Missing Clyde, right? This didn't happen a lot, though. This didn't happen a lot. I just want to make that known that I ain't got a whole 30 playlist of Xavier McKinney missing tackles. I don't have that. But I just need people to understand that, you know, if you want to find tape of people missing tackles, you can find it if you look hard enough, all right? So we could just add this to the whole Delpit McKinney conversation or whatever. I don't think that a tackle misser is a true indication of Xavier McKinney as a player, but we should keep eyes on his super pursuity style. We should keep eyes on that, you know, on sometimes the angles that he'll take or the mismatches against a very sudden guy or a very twitchy guy. It's just something to think about when we're watching film on our own. It's just another layer of things that we can look at and evaluate. But in terms of Xavier McKinney, I like the player. It just depends on it depends on where you want to take him and how much you value strong safety, because I know free safety just as a position, a rangy free safety, is a lot more rare, it's a lot more valuable, and it's harder to find. But it's easier to find strong safeties that can tackle and cover tight ends, you know what I mean? So it just kind of depends on you know what you want to do with that. But that's Xavier McKinney, man, from Alabama. So do y'all research and go in the comment section and tell me what you think about it, man. Somebody gonna ask me, yo Vosh, do you think he's better than Grant Delpit? I don't know, it's too soon.